Hello students, welcome to my class. Today we will study mole concept, and in this video I will explain gas equation, Gay-Lussac's law, Avogadro's law, and I will elucidate the concept of mole concept chapter and make it simple for you to understand, and some of the numericals also I will solve to just give an example. I will try to stick to the syllabus, so children please watch the video properly and then go through your text and solve the exercises. If there are any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will clear them, and the notes will be there in the description box which you can refer to. And please like, share and subscribe my channel. So let's begin. The topics that I'm going to deal today with are gas laws, absolute scale, STP, NTP, Gay-Lussac's law, Avogadro's law, and some numericals. So let's begin with the rules that gas follows. And children, these three, that is the Boyle's law, Charles' law and gas equation, was done last year with the derivation of the facts, but still I would just want to revise once that Boyle's law states that the volume of a given mass of dry gas is inversely proportional to pressure, temperature remaining constant. That means if you increase pressure, volume decreases. If you decrease pressure, volume increases. And thereby the mathematical relation is P1 V1 equals to P2 V2, which is equal to a constant. And Charles' law states that the volume of a given mass of dry gas is directly proportional to temperature, pressure remaining constant, and the mathematical relation is V1 by T1 equals to V2 by T2, which is equal to constant. And on combining the two laws, Boyle's law and Charles' law, the gas equation is given by stating that volume of a given mass of dry gas is inversely proportional to pressure and directly proportional to temperature. Thus, the equation is P1 V1 by T1 equals to P2 V2 by T2, which is equal to constant. We also know about the absolute zero, which we did last year, but let me just revise it once because it's important. That is 0 Kelvin or minus 273 degrees Celsius. And this is the temperature where molecules cease to move. And though difficult to attain, but yes, it is there, 0 Kelvin or minus 273 degrees Celsius. Then we talk about STP or NTP, which you had come across in the numericals last year, that is standard temperature and pressure, or normal temperature and pressure, and the values are 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. That is the standard temperature, where while calculating it mathematically, we always take the temperature in Kelvin. So we have to convert Celsius into Kelvin whenever given in Celsius. Method of converting Celsius to Kelvin and Kelvin to Celsius, we had done it in the junior classes. I'm not revising it once again. And the pressure, that is the standard pressure, is 760 mm of Hg or 76 cm of Hg. That is the height of mercury. As you know, the pressure is measured in. Now, the most important, Gay-Lussac's law of combining volume. So, the Gay-Lussac's law of combining volume states that when gases, it is valid only for gases, okay? So, when gases react, they do so in volumes which bear a simple ratio, a simple whole number ratio to one another and to the volume of the gaseous product also, but provided the temperature and pressure are same, that is at the constant temperature and pressure, when gases react, they do so in a particular ratio, and that ratio is also along with the product, which is gaseous product. I will be explaining also what is Gay-Lussac's law and how mathematical relations are there, numericals based on it. And another law is Avogadro's law. Equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure contains same number of molecules. That means any type of gas should have equal volume, and if the temperature and pressure are same, then the number of molecules consisted in that volume is also same. For example, if I illustrate the Gay-Lussac's law, suppose nitrogen and hydrogen react to give you ammonia, gaseous state, and gaseous state. So when we balance the equation, it is 1, 3, and 2, that is 1 volume of nitrogen, 3 volume of hydrogen, and 2 volume of ammonia. So the ratio is 1 is to 3 is to 2. So just to simplify it, suppose I have 10 centimeter cube of nitrogen, it will react with 30 centimeter cube of hydrogen to give you 20 centimeter cube of ammonia. That means sticking to this ratio, that is 1 is to 3 is to 2. So let me tell you, see, when gases react, they do so in volume, which bear a simple ratio, and also to the volume of the gaseous product. Now to illustrate the Avogadro's law, suppose you have hydrogen, V liter of hydrogen at STP, and this V liter of hydrogen contains X number of molecules, then V liter of oxygen at STP will also contain X number of molecules. So to start with the numericals based on Gay-Lussac's law, the first question that I have written down here, I will be explaining also. What volume of propane is burnt for every 100 centimeter cube of oxygen in a reaction? Now let me explain this this concept. See, propane is one organic compound. Any organic compound, when it reacts with oxygen, will give you carbon dioxide plus water and heat. So we are talking about propane getting oxidized, okay, combustion of propane. This in detail we will do when we do organic chemistry and about writing of their formulas and the method to remain the formula and all that we will do. But as in for now, I have written down the equation also for you, which probably in the question paper also the equation will be written. But I'm sure when we do the chapter organic compound, writing of this equation is also going to be easy for you. For as in now, I have written down the equation: propane C3H8 reacting with oxygen giving you carbon dioxide and hydrogen. On balancing, this is the state. So now when we are talking about Gay-Lussac's law, we said it is valid for gases. So 1 volume, 5 volume, and 3 volume. So the ratio is 1 is to 5 is to 3. But according to the question, we are not asked about CO2. We are only asked about propane reacting with oxygen. So we need propane is to oxygen and the ratio is 1 is to 5. Where we have to find the volume of propane, so we assume it as X, and the volume of oxygen is given, which is 100. So you must have done this proportionality in mathematics, that is 1 is to 5 is as X is to 100, that is 1 by X is equal to 5 by 100. So you know it, product of the means is equal to product of the extremes, from where we got X is equal to 20 centimeter cube. Please take care of the unit. Therefore, 20 centimeter cube of propane is burnt in 100 centimeter cube of oxygen. So there are some of the questions which I have noted down for you. The next one is this. Please read the question, pause the video, and check whether you can solve or not. Try out and then again start the video and see. The question is, calculate the composition of the resultant mixture if 450 centimeter cube of carbon monoxide and 200 centimeter cube of oxygen are mixed and ignited. So try out writing the equation. We have written this equation. Carbon monoxide and oxygen will give you carbon dioxide. Balance the equation and write the ratio and then try. Okay, so this is how we can do it. See, equation balanced. This is the ratio 2:1:2. Now, according to the question, you are giving 450 CO and 200 oxygen. So the ratio of CO, that is carbon monoxide, and oxygen, that is the reactant, is 2:1. So oxygen being 200, CO should be 400 if we go by this relation. 2 by x is 1 by 200, 400. But the amount of carbon monoxide is given, monoxide given to us is 450. So 450 minus 400 is 50 centimeter cube of carbon monoxide unused. So when these two volume of oxygen are put together, 50 centimeter cube of CO still remains, which is unused. Now when I compare oxygen and carbon dioxide, ratio is 1:2. Again, if 200 oxygen, so 400 centimeter cube of CO2 is released. Thus, when we have to find the composition of the resultant mixture, it is 50 centimeter cube of CO unused and 400 centimeter cube of carbon dioxide produced. The next question, again, see the question, write the equation, it is there in the question, balance it and try solving it so that you gain that confidence. Anyway, I will be explaining, so just try out. Now, so H2S plus chlorine gives you 2HCl plus sulfur. This is solid, so we will not consider this. One volume, and two volume. So the ratio is 1:1:2. Now again, just like the previous one, here 112 H2S and 120 chlorine, but the ratio is 1:1. So 112 centimeter cube of H2S will react with 112 centimeter cube of chlorine. Why? Ratio is 1:1, but the amount provided is 120. So 120 minus 112 is 8 centimeter cube of chlorine is unused, whereas H2S is 2HCl is 1:2. See, 1 and 2, 1:2. So 112 centimeter cube of H2S will produce 224 centimeter cube of HCl. So what is the resultant mixture? 8 centimeter cube of chlorine unused and 224 centimeter cube of HCl produced. This is the next question. Read the question, write the equation. See, here you have got STP and also two different values of temperature and pressure. So the question is this, where ethene, so we have written C2H4 plus oxygen gives you CO2 and water. We are not writing now about CO2 because by now you must have understood, if it is not asked in the question, we don't need the ratio. And the question says only the reactants ratio, ethene, oxygen, so the ratio is 1:3. But the volume of oxygen required at STP is asked, whereas the reaction is taking place at 273 degrees Celsius and 380 mm of Hg. So when the ratio is 1:3, 11 liter of C2H4 will need 33 liter. How? 1:3, 11 liter, 33 liter of oxygen at this particular temperature where the reaction is taking place. 273 degrees Celsius, which is actually 546 Kelvin, you know how it is, and 380 mm of Hg. But you have to find the volume at STP. So let's go back here. Gas equation, P1V1 by T1 equals to P2V2 by T2. So what actually is asked in the question is, You are getting 33 liter of oxygen at this temperature and pressure. What is the volume of oxygen at STP? So you have V1, you have T1, you have P1. You have to find V2, where pressure and temperature are standard temperature and pressure, that is 273 Kelvin and 760 mm of Hg. So by substituting the value, V2 is 380 into 33 into 273 by 546 into 760, and the answer is 8.25 liters of oxygen at STP. So you have to understand the question, understand that Gay-Lussac's law stands only at the same temperature and pressure. Here the temperature and pressure are differing. So you have to find the volume of oxygen at the given temperature and pressure and find out its volume at STP. The next question. Please mark the difference. We don't have oxygen any longer in the question. It is air. So try out. Okay. So here again, propane. This was the equation, the first question that I had explained. So propane with oxygen giving you CO2 and oxygen. Again, we are not writing about CO2 because it is not asked in the question. What volume of propane is burnt in 500 centimeter cube of air? So the ratio of propane is to oxygen is 1:5. 1:5. But what is given to us is 500 centimeter cube of air, not oxygen. And propane burns in oxygen, not in air. And it is also known that oxygen is 1/5 of air. So coming back to the rough column, and oxygen 1/5 of air, that is 100 centimeter cube, giving the value of 100 centimeter cube, which is 20 centimeter cube. Thus 20 centimeter cube of propane is burnt in 500 centimeter cube of air. So just be careful with the question, whether the temperature pressure are changing, whether it is oxygen or air removed, whether it is resultant composition where you have to give the ratio of the reactant as well as the product also, or it is only asking about the reactant. So one more question I have written down for Avogadro's law, where I have made a table out of it. Under the same condition of temperature and pressure, find the number of molecules. So if sulfur dioxide with one volume is having x number of molecules, then carbon dioxide with two volume will have 2x number of molecules. Chlorine with three volume will have 3x number of molecules. Hydrogen with five volume will have 5x number of molecules. And nitrogen with four volume will have 4x number of molecules. So let me go back to the content page. I have done with the gas laws explanation, told you what is absolute scale, STP and NTP, gave you the laws stated by Gay-Lussac and Avogadro's, and solved some of the numericals and tried my best to explain it, make it simple. I hope you have understood. Please go through the chapter, solve the exercise, all the numericals. Wherever you have doubt, please put it in the comment section for me to clear it to you. And children, please hit the like button, share, and please subscribe my channel. Do hit the bell icon to get notified of my upcoming video.